We got to Vietnam, and we got to Ho Chi Minh City, and we flew up to Da Nang and then took a three-hour ride from Da Nang down to Quang Nai City, and we had a translator with us. And for the first week, it was our worst fears. We went all over the Quang Nai retracing the steps. We couldn't find anybody that could remember the soldiers or the atrocities. Then we got very lucky. We ended up going into a place called the Songwe Valley. And the Songwe Valley is this remote, timeless basin where generations of people have lived. They haven't moved very far from village to village. There were elders there who remembered the people. They called them the Chicken Patch people because they wore, you know, the emblem of the 101st Airborne, which is an eagle, but to them, they thought it was a chicken. And they remembered the soldiers walking through their villages and some of the atrocities. Now, at this point, we already had put together our own master list of the atrocities. We had about 30. And what we did was we were able to link three of those crimes to witnesses. In other words, we found people who remembered three of the crimes that were in the records. And they were so specific, these crimes, that there was no way they could be wrong. One was a case of five elderly farmers in a field, five women, five men, and it was the middle of the day. And Tiger Force, they were on patrol and they were angry because the night before they'd been hit by snipers. And under the orders of the platoon leader, opened fire. We met one of the men who were nearby. And he said, what happened, well, the bullets hit four of the elderly farmers, killing three of them, and one of them was his father. He remembered that night after the soldiers left, because he hid, and after the soldiers left, crawling through the muck, turning over bodies in the field until he came to his father. And then, with the help of his wife, carried him off and buried him in an unmarked grave.